Oh, Peter Obi.
Yes, sir.
Those in this house, those online that have his contact, tell him to be prayerful. Did you hear me well?
Yes, sir.
You didn't hear me. Tell Peter Obi, those of you online, I love him so much. Those of you are watching who has his contact, tell him to be prayerful before 2020. Where is it? When is the next election? 2027. Ha! I leave it there. Makalu Barazanda. We are in Nigeria. You think this prophet is a fake story? Is something fake? We are just gazing around. Let them not pray. But I'm a prophet. I want to add to the prayers they will pray. That nothing will happen to B2B.
Amen.
I heard three things. Either through a bullet, through an accident, or through a poison.
Yes, sir.
Accident, bullet, poison. Let him be prayerful. I can tell you, as I know my name as Mark Miracle.
Yes, sir.
This is from the depth of the source I got my messages. That we should tell P2B to be prayerful between now and 2027.
Yes, sir.
If I paint the picture of what I saw, prophecies are not to put fear in the heart of people.
Yes, sir.
Seen our prophecies come to pass.
Yes, sir.
Sometimes we no longer put fulfillment of prophecy, because any week we are so busy, we don't get our media, everybody's busy, they don't go back to YouTube to source what we prophesied, to marry it to what we are saying, for the world to see that what we are saying
is true,
actually coming to pass. But you can go back to see fulfilled prophecies. I love PO so much, and as much as I love Atiku, I love Tinubu, I love everybody, every Nigerian, I love them, but Peter Obi should be prayerful. You know, ambush attack.
Yes, sir.
People traveling, all of a sudden ambush people from another place in a bit that they just want to make like kidnap. These three bullets pierce through a car that is supposed to be a bulletproof car. We are prayerful as individuals. Every day we pray for ourselves. God save us. God keep us. Keep us safe from kidnappers. So it's nothing new. P2B is still human being too. Let's pray for him.
Yes, sir.
Don't you pray that God should save you from kidnappers?
Yes, sir.
Don't you pray that God should save you from stray bullets?
Yes, sir.
Yes, it's still not Martin I'm talking. So don't be afraid. It's still not Martin. Let's pray
for P2B
that God should keep him
alive.
Hear me. In case you want to misinterpret, I never said any person wants to kill him.
Yes, sir.
I said he should be
prayerful.
You want to misinterpret, you're on your own. I understand the law so much, and I understand scriptural wisdom. God will give you a word.
Amen.
As prophet, no, I'm not praying now. God will give you a word as a prophet, but you have to ask God for wisdom to deliver it.
Yes, sir.
It's not enough to receive words. You need wisdom to deliver the words. I be Ibrahim Babangida. We should pray for Ibrahim Babangida, IBB. He needs God's serious intervention. He has so long lived, and he has so served the nation, and is still serving the nation. He's a useful tool as long as elder statements are consigned. So God says we should pray for him, because I see IBB needing prayers. Because I see him looking and about to wave goodbye. Am I speaking to somebody now?
Yes, sir.
Hear me. We used to pray against air crash, but there is an auto crash that is about to happen. Auto crash is landed accident that will take lives of people that will make Nigerians weep. But God says between this month, this date, and the end of this month, we should intensify prayers against blood-sucking demons. Because you see families that are complete in a vehicle, all of a sudden the devil wipes them out. accident happens every day and everywhere, but this type I am telling you is disastrous. So this being the last message I have this night, we raise our hands as a church.
Yes, sir.
You will not die in auto crash.
Amen.
Nobody connected to this church will die in auto crash.
Amen.
Nobody watching online connected to this prophetic altar will die in auto crash.
Amen.
As I have spoken, so shall it be.
Amen.
In the name of God the Father.
Amen.
Of the Son.
Amen.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
So guys, you heard what Pastor Mike Miracle has to say concerning Peter Obi and what is about to happen to Peter Obi. So guys, please, let's do well to put Peter Obi in our prayer, in our daily prayer, in everything, because see, a lot of prophecies has been dropping concerning Peter Obi for the past 1 year till now, since the presidential election took place and all that. And see, as you all know, if you know and if you have been following my channel for a very long time, you see that I've been bringing a lot of prophecies by prophets Mike Miracle, and any prophecies he give always come to pass. They make their way to come to pass, and he always says that let's pray against it, so that even though it's going to come to pass, it's not as serious as it is. But for the level of the way he's talking concerning Peter Obi's prophecies and all that, I feel like we shouldn't take it for granted. We should take it very serious and pray and commit this man into the hands of God. As you all know, see, there are arrows fighting him from every angle, every division of life and all that. See, let's just pray for this man so that nothing happened to him. Let's avoid how come, like, all those things over his life. He's a human being like us, irrespective of anything, in as much as people say they like him, they want him, he speaks the truth, he's the man of the people and all that, he speaks the heart of the people. Let's keep politics aside for now and just pray for this man so that nothing happens to him. He has children, he has a very young wife and all that, he has family, that if anything should happen to him, they are going to miss him, their life is going to be very, very devastated and all that. He's the head of his family, and he's their source of happiness and all those things. He provides for his family, all that. So let's put him in prayer, even though not for him to be the president of Nigeria. And he's saying that these things he's seeing is from now till 2027. And as you all know, 2027 is just around the corner. That is one thing you need to know. Before you know, time flies, like it passes you by, and you don't even know that this time has actually come to this particular time and all that. Before you know, next year it's 2 years already. Before you know, campaigning will start small. 2026, before you know, campaign is everywhere. Then before you know, boom, election is just here and all that. So please, let's do it to put him in prayer so that nothing happened to him, no harms come to him, because he says that he sees either by motor crash or by flying bullets or straight bullets and all that, or by poisoning and all that. See, I always warn people, if you're not sure if your environment, please don't keep what you want to eat, or don't even eat at all. Tell them you are fasting. See, with the way Nigeria is going, you need to fast every day. So anywhere that you are that is not home, that you feel like what you're going to eat is not safe, even friends kill friends and all that. So do well to say you are fasting and avoid to eat at that place. If you're on a road, you can buy snacks and eat and all that. Where somebody does not know you and all those things, to avoid story that touches the heart and all that. That is just my own take and everything on this video, because it's not easy for somebody to just boom lose his life like that. See, life is so precious and all that. With what we are facing as a nation, I feel like a lot of people are looking forward to 2027 presidential election and all that, and hoping that Peter Obi will emerge as the president of Nigeria when 2027 comes, so that they feel like they can trash out all these, they are rigging and all that. A lot of people are still rooting, hoping that one day Peter Obi is going to sit on that seat, and it's not going to be far from now, and it's going to be 2027. So what if he's no more? What is going to happen? So the best we can do is just to pray for him so that no harms come to him, nothing happened to him, nor his family and all that. And also put our political leaders in mind in prayers, and say God should touch their hearts to make sure that they do what they are assigned to office to do at the end of the day, so that they are not there to just loot our money, make the nation go bankrupt and all that. Let's just put them in prayer and everything. As you all know, you saw what happened to President Bola Ahmed Tinubu yesterday at the Eagle Square. It was not easy when he was trying to address the nation for democracy and all that. You saw how his agbada just tumbled him over. He tumbled like there was no tomorrow. So please, let's do it to put prayers for this political leader. In as much as anything, they are also still doing their best. They are still trying. It's not easy, honestly. It's not easy when it comes to the case of Nigeria to say you are a political leader or you are a father figure. It's not easy, honestly. So, and another thing he says that they should pray for IBB, General Ibrahim Babangida. As you all know, see, as for IBB's own, a lot of people have been saying that, oh, he's gone, he has kicked the bucket and all that. Yes, we know that that man is sick, seriously sick and all that. But in as much as anything, let's still put him in prayer. Like he says, these are godfathers in Nigeria and all that. Whether a lot of people will be like, oh, they contribute bad thing to the nation, they always put their people to be there to tear the nation down and all that. See, these people, they are still doing underground work in Nigeria. If you don't know, please know and have it in mind. There are some things that have to go through them before it's been approved or published on air and all that. Even presidents cannot even act on their own. They have to come and consult these people like oracles and all that. So let's pray for him so that nothing happens to him. Let's pray for him that he gets better and all that. Yes, he has lived. He has lived quite long, but as you can see, a lot of people are still 80, even still coming to become president of Nigeria at the end of the day. I know that those that ruled during military regime still came to rule during democracy and all that. So please, let's keep on praying. Let's put Nigeria in prayer and say that, oh, nothing should happen to our godfathers and all that, and especially General Ibrahim Babangida, because his name was actually mentioned in this prophecy that we should pray and put him in prayer so that nothing, no arms come to him at the end of the day. So let's pray for him, and also let's pray for Tinubu. Like I say, we don't really know what happened to him. Yes, you could see that probably he stood up later and all that, but you don't know which pain he's going through and all that. And before you know, you start hearing budget upon budget, this upon that, to fly the president outside. He has broken his hand, he has broken his leg. Unnecessary expenses will start coming in. So let's pray to avoid such these things, because people has been dropping prophecies concerning what is going to happen to him and all that. But see, you saw what happened to him yesterday. Honestly, in as much as we made it look funny, or even people went as far as creating content out of it and all that, this is a human being like us. So let's keep that in mind. Let's have that at the back of our mind, honestly, because I wouldn't want injustice and all that. I wouldn't wish him pain and all that. He's an elderly man. Just imagine your grandfather at home in pain and all that. How do you feel within you? Let's forget, irrespective of anything, him being the president of Nigeria or anything, we don't want such thing to happen to him. Yes, I know people are dying and all that. I understand everybody, because I'm also pained, but let's do well to also understand that this man is also a human being. He has blood flowing through his vein. So any way we can intercede for him, please, let's do. He's a human being, and we pray that what happened to him yesterday was not as serious as it looks like. And please, I'm sure that they will definitely address the nation to tell what actually really went down. So that is just my take and order. But before I go, please, if you've not subscribed to our channel, kindly pause this video, subscribe, comment, like, share with family and friends so that you don't miss out on any of our content. And also don't forget to turn on the post notification to get notified whenever I upload a new video. And if you're a returning subscriber, I want to use this opportunity to say a very big thank you. Thank you for always tuning in. Thank you for always subscribing to tuning to our channel. God bless you as you do that all the time. So guys, that is just it. That is what I just decided to bring your way. So please put those people in great prayer, especially Peter Obi, because the prophecy was very, very serious when it comes to him and all that. Thank you very much for watching this video. I'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.